हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू मार्केट बिहेवियर एंड कॉस्ट एनालिसिस क्लास। इन टुडेज़ क्लास वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन प्रॉफिट मैक्सिमाइजेशन एंड वेल्थ मैक्सिमाइजेशन। इन प्रीवियस टू क्लासेस वी हैव लर्नड व्हाट इज़ प्रॉफिट मैक्सिमाइजेशन एज वेल एज वेल्थ मैक्सिमाइजेशन। ओके, आई विल गिव यू brief introduction of profit maximization as well as wealth maximization, and then we will begin with differences of profit maximization and wealth maximization. Now, what is profit maximization? Now, profit maximization, it focuses on increasing profit of the company. Okay, it is also called as it is an primary objective of any organization. Now, it is a basic requirement of any entity. Without a profit, the business will not run, because otherwise it will be loss of its capital and it cannot be able to survive for a longer period of time. Okay, but when we are earning profit, risk is also directly associated with profit. Okay, so we all know, like, where there is high risk, there will be high profit. Higher the profit, higher will be the risk. So for gaining more amount of profit, finance manager has to take such decisions which will give a boost to the profitability of the concern. Okay, now we will see few points related to wealth maximization. Now, what is wealth maximization? Wealth maximization, it focuses on market value of its firm. Okay, now what is market value? Now, market value of the firm, it is based on many factors. Okay, like their goodwill, sales it might be, or services, or quality of products, and many other factors. Now, its aim is to increase the value of stakeholders, as stakeholders are the owners of the undertaking. Okay, and they buy the shares of the company with the expectation that it will give some returns after a period. Okay, so wealth maximization is nothing but it is increasing the market value of the firm. Fine. Okay, now we will see a few differences between profit maximization and wealth maximization. Now, first point, it is related to concept. Okay, now in profit maximization, the main objective of a concern is to earn a larger amount of profit. It is the main objective to increase the profit. Now, in case of wealth maximization, the ultimate goal of the concern is to improve the market value of its shares. So, main objective is what? To increase the market value of its shares. Second point is, in profit maximization, it emphasizes on achieving short-term objective. It means what? Like, profit maximization means to increase our profit, to earn more and more profit. So it will be for shorter period of time. So for this particular year, to increase profit, like, whatever activities has to be conducted will be undertaken by the firm. So it will be for a short term period of time. In case of wealth maximization, it emphasizes on achieving a long term objective. It means if you are increasing the market value of the firm, it will be for a longer period of time. Okay, now next point, in profit maximization, it ignores risk and uncertainty. Okay, in profit maximization, it will ignore risk and uncertainty, because it will be there for a short term period of time. So where there is high profit, there will be higher risk. So even if there is risk and uncertainty, the company will ignore it and they will try to increase more and more profit. In case of wealth maximization, it considers both risk and uncertainty, because they will have to increase their market value. So whenever you are increasing market value of the share, there will be more risk and uncertainty. So all those has to be undertaken by the company, only then they can increase their market value of the share. Next, in profit maximization is, it avoids time value of money. It means it will not consider the time value. It means what? Now, what is time value of money? Time value of money means it is the difference between an amount of money in the present and that same amount of money in the future. Okay, so usually we say that having money now is more valuable than having money later. It means what? Suppose if today you have 1000 rupees. So after 3 to 4 years, if you have same 1000 rupees, the value of money has reduced. Okay, so whatever you are going to purchase of 1000 rupees today, you will get it, you will get more products for 1000 rupees. But same 1000, if you are using it for the future period, so in 1000 you may not get many things as you are purchasing it present. So that is what is time value of money. So in profit maximization, it avoids time value of money because we are going to achieve short term objective for profit maximization. In case of wealth maximization, it recognizes the time value of money. It means it will consider the time value of money because the only the thing is what? To increase the market value of the shares. So whenever you are increasing the market value, it means you will have to consider the time value of money. It means you are going to give returns to your shareholders. So shareholders will think before they invest, because if they think the returns will be more in the future, only then they will be investing. So in wealth maximization, we consider time value of money. Next is, in profit maximization, it is necessary for survival and growth, because without profit the organization will not run. It is a primary objective. Okay, so for survival and growth, profit is necessary. In case of wealth maximization, it accelerates the growth rate of the enterprise and aims at attaining the maximum market share of the company. So the main objective is not to earn profit, but to increase the market share. Okay, next, in case of profit maximization, it increases price of the product to earn more profit. So here, because the main objective is to earn more profit, so whenever the price of the product is increased, only then there will be more profit to the company. So here they will increase the price of the product, okay, so that they can reach the objective of profit maximization. In case of wealth maximization, it reduces the price in order to build market share over the long term. It means what? The main intention is to increase the market share. Okay, so they will reduce the price of the product. So once they reduce the price of the product, then they will get more stakeholders to the firm. So when they retain those shareholders or stakeholders, it might be, or anybody who is related. So whenever they are reducing the price, so that will help them to increase the market share for a long period of time. Okay, so this is what is difference between profit maximization and wealth maximization. Okay, hope so this class is clear to you all. In the next class, we will be discussing another aspect of first unit. Thank you.